But that Freddy picture, right? I mean, I look at it, he looks like he's on his way to bloody heaven. But they approached me, you know, Mick Rock, because he's taking pictures of famous puffs, you know. I mean, they wanted to look the fucking part. Because they got this first album out and nothing much is happening with it. They wanted the glam rock image. I had a friend who had a collection of old Hollywood stills. And it was the cover shot, but it might have been from the same movie, Shanghai Express. He had a little book about Marlene Dietrich's films, and inside was the shot that did inspire. My brain just went and I showed it to Freddie, and it was, you know, it was an instant sell. Freddie Mercury, you can, as it were, be Marlene Dietrich. Of course, she was a total professional and basically could light herself. These guys, it's only the second time they'd ever been in a photographic studio, and they were in and out of that mirror. They were up and I was up and down this bloody ladder. And you can see from these Polaroids the development of that shot. I don't know if I was super nervous about it or whatever, man. I did not let go. Freddie was the one I communicated with most, because he, I don't know, he was camp and he was like, he was the visionary. As Roger said about Freddie, I mean, he would, even when he didn't have a pot to piss in, he was crashing on your floor, he'd walk in, acting like he was doing you a favor. Oh, he was already playing in Colosseums in his mind. We showed it to the band and they said, fine, we'll do it. But we're also gonna shoot this white shot. See, look, album gatefold would have been, and ended up being the middle of it anyway. So these, they were like, I think maybe the white one. Of course, it would have looked like Santa Claus is coming to town.